My mentor is a street vendor. My aunt has been buying vegetables from Lakshmi Bai from last 20 years. Typically, she wakes up at 3:30 in the morning. At 4 o'clock, she goes to Kormangla in Bangalore, takes money at 10% interest on a daily basis. That's 3,650%. She takes 1,000 rupees in the morning and buys vegetables. She pays 50 rupees for the cart. She goes around the whole day selling vegetables. At evening 8 o'clock, she has to decide what should be the pricing of the vegetables because she has no refrigerator at home. At the end of the day, she has to repay that 1,000 rupees to the moneylender and then has enough money to actually go and feed her 3 kids. What she has done is 2 things: brilliant financial engineering, and second is brilliant social sustainability. She's delivering vegetables at your doorstep and what you actually need. She has balanced, without an MBA, a double bottom line: financial and social sustainability. Now I talk about the street vendor in Ahmedabad. She bought a solar light from us. The best financial lesson I have learned is from a street vendor who said 300 rupees a month is expensive, but 10 rupees a day is fine. The question is, because her cash flow was on a daily basis, so she bought a 5-year financed solar light that she could pay on a daily basis of 10 rupees. After a month, she came back and bought one more light. After a month, another light, and after a month, another light in 4 months. So when I went to her house, I actually did not see a single light in her house. What she does is she takes the 4 lights along with her during the evening at 6 o'clock and rents out the other 3 lights to her 3 neighboring street vendors. And she collects 10 rupees from them. So they are saving 5 rupees. She is now able to actually have 30 rupees and pays her mortgage to the bank. Brilliant, right? Brilliant entrepreneurship. What has she done? She is socially sustainable. She's financially sustainable. She's environmentally sustainable. There are already 300,000 poor in this country buying solar without subsidies, showing us the way that how sustainable living, using so-called expensive technologies like solar, you can live a life without subsidies, without harming the environment. And what a beautiful connection between sustainable energy and poverty alleviation without actually talking about climate change. And that is what we've been actually trying to do from last 18 years. Poor are actually going to teach all of us how to consume less, how to actually protect the environment, and do a sustainable business. The happiness today can actually be found in the poor of our country in a sustainable manner. Thank you very much.